Our topic is about the best practices to be adopted by a certain worker, especially if she or he belongs to an organization or large group. Okay? Actually, our discussion is according to own experience. And I believe that it could help any worker in dealing with his work, especially during transition period, wherein the latter not yet master his work in general and duties and responsibilities in particular. Kasi basic procedure nga naman na isang manggagawa pag hindi alam ang kanyang trabaho because of lack of knowledge or whatsoever ay kailangang magtanong sa kanyang kasamahan o kung hindi man yung kanyang mga opisyal sa organization. Okay? And the most important is it could help any worker in developing his personality, not only of being a worker but also as individual. Okay? Kasi itong topic kasing ito ay hindi lang applicable sa buhay ng isang manggagawa, pero bagkus applicable ito sa lahat. Okay? Now, there are 4 best practices that I will be going to discuss in order to clarify and determine their essence and importance. Okay? So, they are consultation, communication, coordination, and cooperation. And I just want to make it clear that these are interrelated and intertwined to each other. In other words, it is a must that all of these are present, or any worker must possess them all in order for him or her to become a good team player in his organization in particular, or a good kind of worker in general. Now, let us discuss something about the first one, which is consultation. So, there is an old saying that 2 heads are better than 1. No, and such certainly manifests that any worker should oblige to ask his or her coworkers, especially supervisors or leaders, about any job-related issues that he needs to know so he can carry out his work properly. Napaka-importante yun na gagawin ng isang worker, lalo pag hindi talaga alam ang kanyang gagawin. Okay? Yes, this is so momentous, especially that things or learning to be learned is not included in the operational system and policy of the company that he needs to follow in dealing with his work. Mahalaga yun para hindi magkaroon ng problema at siyempre mahusay na maisagawa ang kanyang mandato sa trabaho. But why some workers failed to ask their leaders in times of disputes or lack of knowledge about their job? Bakit kaya no nagkakaroon ng ganitong problema? Actually, it is practical in human nature that some workers refusing to ask their coworkers or supervisors. This is very natural because of their own reasons. But again, according to experience, there are 2 reasons kung bakit. Number 1 is because of shyness, no, of being known or identified as ignorant from the eyes of their coworkers. Yung iba kasi nahihiya talaga na malaman ng kanilang kasamang empleyado na hindi nila alam ang kanilang ginagawa. No? That is one. Number 2 is due to fear of being criticized or condemned by their supervisors, which is not supposed to be. Kasi yung iba nga iba din ay natatakot na malaman ng supervisor at siyempre ayaw nilang mapagalitan o mapagsabihan. Okay? But again, basic protocol kasi yun that if you don't know something about your work or job, then the best effort for you to do is to ask and seek the assistance of your coworkers, no, lalong-lalo na yung officers mo for that matter. No? Actually, that is the best move. Hindi lang yun ideal move. Yun ay practical pa. Okay? But anyway, in this particular issue, a certain leader must adjust himself. That requires his ability to determine the needs of his subordinates for that matter. Actually, dito natin nasusukat ang kakayahan ng isang namumuno kung alam niyang i-determine yung mga pangailangan ng kanyang mga tauhan. And of course, he can do it by means of an effective and efficient observation and supervision over his men. Okay, now, the problem is if your supervisor doesn't know how to deal with this kind of situation or particular circumstance. No, ano mangyayari? Automatic yun, kuidaw ka. No, hindi mo alam ang iyong gagawin. No? That's why if you are a good worker, belongs to a large group, then you must know how to execute and observe this kind of protocol for you to cope up and deal properly with everything surrounding your work. Because at the end of the day, you are responsible and accountable to what you do inside your workplace. Yun yung problema. No, ano man yung mangyari, siyempre, ikaw yung mananagot sa anumang gawain mo. Okay, so kailangan you need to cope up and deal with this kind of situation. Okay? Anyway, these are the important points of discussion as far as consultation is concerned. And hopefully our viewers could learn a little bit about this discussion. Our next subtopic is communication and I will tackle it in my next vlog. Okay? So hanggang sa muli, laging tandaan na iwasan natin ang fake news, huwag magpalinlang at ugaliing magsiyasat. Salud at mabuhay!